Welcome back. In this episode, we are going to address how to calculate the rule of 72. Why is this important? Because this is one of the dynamic ways to simply empower you to have double or triple the amount of money when you understand how to employ the rule of 72 to be able to double your money every 7 to 10 years. I'm Doug Andrew, and I've helped many people for 45 years understand the rule of 72 and how to use it for two particular calculations. But there's a third one that I can even stump many CPAs with. So let's talk about what it is and how it simplifies math and calculating rates of return, or how long it will take for you to double your money. It's an interesting phenomenon where you can take any interest rate you're earning on your money and you divide that interest rate into the number 72, and that will tell you how many years it will take to double your money. So let's say you're earning 8% interest. 8 into 72 is 9 times. So your money will double every 9 years. If you started out with $10,000, it'll double to $20,000. $20,000 doubles to $40,000. $40,000 doubles to $80,000 every 9 years at 8% interest. Well, if you're earning 9%, 9 into 72 means it will double every 8 years. If you're only earning 5%, then it will take 14.4 years, almost 15 years to double your money. And so if you work for 30 years, you're only doubling your money twice during your whole working career if you're only earning 5%. What if you were to earn 10%, like I have for many, many years? 10 into 72 means your money will double every 7.2 years. Are you getting it? It's sort of like the reciprocal of that equation is also true. In other words, if you want to calculate the compounded interest equivalent of a particular investment, let's say that you bought a piece of real estate and you paid $100,000 for it. Now, sometimes people would come into me and say, I paid $100,000 for this piece of property and I just sold it and doubled my money. I go, well, I'm not that impressed until I know what. Two things. How long did you hold on to it before you sold it for double? And did you pay cash? Did you tie up all your money? Or did you use the third marble leverage? Did you use OPM? How much did you tie up? Now, if you tied up all your money, you paid cash, and you sold it for double, and I say, how long? Oh, I had it for 10 years. 10 years into 72 means that your real estate appreciated an average of 7.2% per year. That's really not that impressive, really. I mean, that's the national average. Did you know that? So you can take an interest rate, divide it into 72, and it will tell you how long it will take to double your money. What if you're earning 1% at the bank? 1 into 72? It will take you 72 years to double your money? I don't want to wait that long. So that's pretty pathetic. And if you're investing and you're doubling your money, but it takes you 15 or 20 years to sell something for double what you paid for it, that's not a very good rate of return either. So how do you harness the power of this? You want to be able to earn rates of return more like 6, 7, 8, 9, 10%. And I prefer tax-free, because if you're earning a 10% rate of return, but that is being taxed, you're only really netting like 6 or 7. You want to calculate it using the net internal rate of return. What is really your money? I'm going to share with you another little question that I even stump CPAs with. So in other episodes, I talk about the negative impact that inflation has. When people retire, there are two things that sort of erode away their retirement income or savings: taxes and inflation. So let's talk about inflation for a moment. How the cost of living goes up, the price of gallons of gas, loaves of bread, haircuts, whatever. So let's say that inflation averages 5%. And so you're retiring, and you think you can get by with $3,000 a month out of your tax-deferred IRA or 401k to supplement other income, maybe a pension because you taught school and your Social Security. So you go, okay, I think I can barely make it on $3,000 a month coming out of that. If I take any more, it's going to probably begin to deplete that. And I don't want to outlive my money. Well, I ask CPAs. So if you can get by on $3,000 a month today, and inflation averages 5%, using the rule of 72, calculate real fast, how much will you need to buy the same gallons of gas and loaves of bread that you used to buy for $3,000 a month at 5% inflation if you live 30 years? And they go, now say what? At 5% inflation, how much will you need to have an income to buy the same gallons of gas and loaves of bread that you bought 30 years ago for $3,000 a month? And they go, I don't know, I need a calculator. This is a rule of 72 equation. You ready? So you take 5% inflation, divide that into 72, okay? That will go about 14.4. Let's just round it to 15. That means every 15 years, the cost of living will double. Or another way to look at it, the purchasing power of that $3,000 is cut in half. In other words, in less than 15 years, you would need $6,000 a month to buy the same gallons of gas, haircuts, golf green fees that $3,000 a month bought 15 years earlier. In another 15 years, it doesn't go up another $3,000, it doubles again. You would need $12,000 a month to buy the same goods and services that $3,000 bought just 30 years earlier. So if you're retiring at age 60, 65, and one of you will make it probably to age 95, that's the fastest growing segment of American society today, those people reaching over the age of 100. And if all of a sudden you retired thinking, well, I can get by on $3,000 a month, but that's about it, you're gonna need $12,000 a month to buy the same lifestyle that you used to get for $3,000 a month, unless you employ strategies to have inflation work for you instead of against you, which is another episode I would invite you to view. But folks, you can use the rule of 72 to calculate the negative impact of inflation, and you must be rowing upstream at a rate of return greater than the inflation rate. What does this mean? What if inflation goes to 7.2%? Actually, it has. That means the cost of living would double every 10 years. 7.2 into 72 is every 10 years. There are a lot of things that have gone up in value more than 10%, like healthcare costs. 10% inflation into 72, what causes inflation? Irresponsible government spending and the printing of money. If inflation averages 10%, 10 into 72 means every 7.2 years, you'll need twice as much money to buy the same gallons of gas and loaves of bread that it purchased just 7 years earlier. So if you live 30 years, the cost of living will double four times. So what does this mean? It means that if you understand how to harness the power of the rule of 72, it should become a no-brainer to understand, golly, to not outlive my money in retirement, I need to earn predictable, safe rates of return of probably at least 7.2%, maybe 10%. But the key is, if you're earning those returns tax-free, that's a huge benefit. And that's what I've learned through over 45 years being a financial and tax strategist. I have predictably earned, in the worst decade since the Great Depression, 2000 to 2010, I averaged 7.23% using indexing, a strategy that we teach in other episodes, and it happens to be the very strategy in my favorite vehicle called the Laser Fund. But 7.23% means that any money I had in the year 2000, without adding a dime, I had $2 million 10 years later. Most Americans were just barely back to break even. But see, by using another strategy that we teach, I'm able to earn more like 10%. 10 into 72 means my money doubles every 7.2 years. What does this mean for you? Let's say you have $500,000 right now. And by the way, it's not what you begin with that counts, it's what you end up with. But you can extrapolate from this number. $500,000, if you earn 7.2%, will double every 10 years. At 10%, about every 7.2 years. This is why I've helped many, many people with $500,000 double to $1 million, double again to $2 million, double again to $4 million, and the last 7.2 years it doubled to $8 million in a 30-year period. And $8 million earning 10% allows you to take out as much as $800,000 a year without depleting your principal. That is the power of understanding the rule of 72 for you. So in review, what are some big takeaways? How to use the rule of 72 to calculate how long it will take to double your money. Also, you can calculate the compounded interest equivalent on any investment that you sell for double in a certain time period. But also you can calculate the negative impact of inflation and how much you will need more than the inflation rate to not outlive your money. I would encourage you to now learn the power of compound interest, because this is where the rule of 72 comes into full play to help you accumulate the most and not outlive your money. Click on this episode, and of course, any of the links below will help you learn even more in depth through various educational materials that I prepared for you.